Hi, I am PixelPia. Last week, I asked you what Google software you would like me to do a tutorial about. And the choices were Google Voice or Google Meet. Most of you chose Google Voice. So that is what we're doing today. We will start by taking a look at what is Google Voice and who can use it. Google Voice is a voice over internet protocol, a VoIP phone service that allows users to make and receive phone calls, send text messages, and forward calls from one number to another. It also offers call screening, call blocking, voicemail transcriptions, and other features. Google Voice works using VoIP technology to let you make and receive both calls and text via an internet connection. All it needs to support calling is a speaker and a microphone. That includes your cell phone, your computer, or a tablet. Google Voice has apps for Android, iOS, and the web. It syncs across your devices, so you can use the app in the office, at home, or on the go. The basic service is free, but several paid options are available for an additional fee. For business use, with Google Workspace, you need to select a paid plan. There are three options to choose from, and each can easily be added to your Workspace account. Google Voice won't replace a cell phone carrier's plan. VoIP service like Google Voice's phone plan requires an internet connection to send, receive, and route calls. That means it only works if you are on a reliable landline connection or very good Wi-Fi. How do you get Google Voice and why should you? So here we are at Google Voice. And as you can see, we can choose account for personal use or for business, as I said. In this tutorial, we will only talk about Google Voice for personal use. So first, I need to sign in and welcome to Google Voice. In this case, I am not going to actually set up a number because I have one for my other account. But first, we're going to take a look at terms of service. I'm showing the terms of service quickly here. But you can pause and read through it, or you can look at Google's website. I will have a link to the terms of service down below. If we accept all that, we click Continue. And here is where you search for a phone number. You can start by putting in your area code. For me, it's 850. And they show you a selection of numbers you can choose from. When you find one that you like, you just click Select. And now we come to Verify. Here you have to use your cell phone number by clicking here and enter your phone number, and they will send a link to that phone number where you get a verification code. I will not do that right now, but say that I did. The next step will be to log in here to my voice home screen. So from here, we can do a lot of things. We can place a call. We can send a text message. We can listen to our voicemail, or we can read our voicemail. We can archive things, and if we get spam, they will end up in here. Today, I will just go through the basic settings here. We have our phone number. We can delete it if we don't want it anymore. We have the devices where I have used it so far, just the web. We have a link number. We have messages. Here we can set up forward messages to your email, call. Always use my phone to place calls. I don't have that on because I want to have the possibility to use the web. Anonymous caller ID. Hide your caller ID on outgoing call. And all of these can be put on or off. Incoming calls. Turn on the device you want to answer your phone. And I have it set to my cell phone in this case. I can choose the web and the cell phone. So if I'm online and someone calls, it will pop up on the web. And then we can set up rules for call forwarding. We will not do that today. And then different types of alerts we can have coming in. I will not go through all of that today. Voicemail. Here you can record a greeting and you can have several greetings. You can get your voicemail via email. You can add on the transcripts, or you can have so you call to listen. You can set up web notifications. And here you can add credits if you need to use any of the paid services. And here we show up your payments, your security here, filter spam calls. I have that on. Accessibility, you can use high contrast settings. And then we have privacy and terms again. Up here, you can set to receiving calls or do not disturb. Here you can set up your audio settings, your microphone, your speakers, or your ringing device. This is for the web. On my phone, it will work just like a regular phone call, the settings I have there. Here, as all Google apps, you have more help articles about Google Voice. And then you have your little Google Apps and you have your little account. So that was the very basic. So who can use it? Or when would you need a second phone number? Well, there might be many reasons. Maybe you want one phone number that you use as your work phone, if they call you from your work, and another number that you use privately. Or maybe you have a little side hustle where you create something that you sell. You want a second number that you can give to your customers for your baked goods or your Etsy store or something like that. Then it can be very useful to have Google Voice phone. But remember, if you don't use it within a 3-month period, you will lose. If you would like me to get into more details about all the settings, make sure you make a comment down below. Otherwise, I am ready to move on from Google Voice. It is if you need a second phone number that you can use on your cell phone, on your tablet, or on the web. And it is that easy to set up. Until next time, bye.